Hello guys, today I have come with a new video in which I will discuss the play The Ladies Not for Warning by Christopher Fry. The main characters of this play are Thomas Mandy, a discharged soldier, Zenith Jardiman, an accused witch, Havel Tyson, the mayor of the town called Pool Clady, Humphrey and Nicholas, who are nephews of the mayor, Margaret Davis, the mother of Humphrey and Nicholas and sister of the mayor, Zenith Ellison, a fiance of Humphrey, Richard, an orphaned clerk of the mayor of the town, Matthew Skiffs, a rat and bone man who is turned into a dog. Begins with Thomas Mandy, who wants to die by hanging in front of Thomas and the people of the town. But instead of focusing on him, the entire town focuses on Zenith Jardiman, who is accused of witchcraft, that she has turned old Skiffs, that means Matthew Skiffs, into a dog. Moreover, Humphrey Davis, the nephew of the mayor, has been betrothed to Elizon Elliot. Since she is coming to meet him very soon, no one has time to deal with Thomas, who is none but a fool to the people of the town. Elizon's father has 6 daughters. He is very afraid that he has so many daughters to marry off. But ultimately, he very easily has married off her other 5 daughters and promised Elizon to Humphrey. But the problem is, Elizon, Humphrey's brother, thinks that he deserves Elizon. So he is out to knock his brother down and to have Elizon for himself. Meanwhile, Havel finds that Thomas wants to be hanged in front of him. He becomes angry. He is fed with people making ridiculous effects or ridiculous requests. So he thinks that people are mocking his hard work. He threatens to have Thomas tortured unless he leaves and stops his brother. When Thomas' interview with Havel is interrupted by Nicholas, who demands to get into the mayor's office, Zenith walks in. She is angry because she is accused that she has turned old Skiffs into a dog, and the people of the town call or regard her a witch. Havel and his associates are overloaded and they have a lot of problems on their hands about Thomas and Zenith. They decide to leave Thomas and Zenith in a room alone in order to listen to them, because they think that Zenith may confess her crimes to Thomas when they will be alone. When they left alone, Zenith tells Thomas that her father was a scientist. She promises that she will have no such nonsense. She will be completely factual unless tomorrow she is burned. She also confesses that her fancy and imagination have caused her present trouble. Overhearing this conversation, Hebel convinces that she is a witch. He also decides to send her property to city when she will be burned, because Zinit was a wealthy woman. The wealthy woman. From this conversation, Hebel also comes to know that Thomas wants to be hanged because he finds life mean and dull. So his punishment is to spend the night in joy and revelry at the party, celebrating the betrothal of Humphrey and Elizon. But Thomas is not agreed to attend the party unless Zinit is allowed to go with him. Ultimately, dressed in one of Margaret's old gowns, Zinit is sent to the party where Humphrey no longer wants Elizon. Neither Humphrey nor Nicholas claims for her. She, unknown to both of them, has found that she loves Richard, and Richard also returns her love. Richard and Elizon finally slip away and are married by the priest, who found Richard in a poor box when he was completely a tiny baby. Unhappily, Thomas and Zinit also fall in love with each other. They were unhappy because Thomas has no wish to be in love. Life is enough miserable to him. On the other hand, Zinit doesn't want to renounce her sexual world for love and fancy. Zinit also knows that Thomas has not murdered. He just murdered the rackman in order to divert suspicion from her. Meanwhile, Humphrey goes to Zinit and offers her to get her free from wizardry if she entertains him at her cell that night. Though the body of Zinit wants or loves the thought of living, but her mind and heart rebels. Ultimately, she turns down his offer. She loves Thomas too much to take life at any risk. At the end of the play, we find, fortunately, the old skiffs is found alive. Hebel is not satisfied because he is coveted with Zinit's property. But a soft-hearted justice allows Thomas and Zinit to slip out of the town in the dark. Though Thomas hates to face living again, but ultimately decides to forgo the pleasure of dying for another 50 years and spend the time waiting with Zinit. If we analyze the play, we find some most important themes of the play. The first one is the theme of heresy and reflection of the 15th century, that means Middle Ages, in the play. Zinit is accused, Thomas claims to be a devil. But the town, that means the people of the town, focuses on Zenit instead of Thomas. This represents that represents the 15th century, that means the Middle Ages, in which the women are accused and killed. Moreover, the town in this play is described as a little market town, which also symbolizes the 15th century society, in which the women are accused instead of the men. There we find a gender bias. If Zenit was in place of Thomas and Thomas in Zenit's, then we will find that Thomas will be accused. Thomas will not be accused. Zenit will be accused. Zenit is accused not because that she has turned old skills into a dog. She is accused because of her gender biasness. Another important theme of the play is deceit. Thomas deceives the people into believing that he is a murderer only to get their attention. Though apparently he wants to be hanged, but her actual intention was to draw the attention of the people. Similarly, Nicholas deceives Elizon into believing that he has knocked his brother down only to have her. Moreover, Humphrey also deceives Zenit when he goes to her to give her freedom. But the actual intention of Humphrey was to seduce Zenit. And here, important theme is the escapism from this world. In this play, Thomas represents a particular section of people. Thomas wants to be hanged, and his hanging here symbolizes the escapism from this mundane and disillusioned world. Thank you.